Number one prayer point, Lord, give me divine direction and instruction in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, what? Give me divine direction and instruction in the name of Jesus Christ. Some of us have never had divine direction. Let me tell you something. If God loves you, if you are living in sin, God will tell you. Maybe you are, you have a wrong relationship with somebody, or you are dating somebody. God will tell you, leave her and get out of her life, or leave him and get him out of your life. That's the way God will speak to you. You will know. You will know. So let's pray. Lord, give me divine direction in the name of. Let me begin to pray in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that you give me divine direction. From this day forward, give me divine direction all the days of my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray. This is the greatest treasure from heaven. When God guides, when God leads, your problems are over. Lord, give me divine direction. Give me divine instructions all the days of my life. From this day forward, let me see clearly, let me hear clearly. Divine guidance, divine instructions, divine direction in the name of Jesus Christ. By the Holy Spirit, I receive divine instruction, divine direction every day, all the days of our life. Thank you, Father, in this pandemic season, Lord, give me divine instruction, give me divine direction in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. The next prayer point. Lord, don't let me be a victim of spiritual deafness and blindness in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, don't let me what? A victim of spiritual what? Deafness and blindness in my life. Listen to me very carefully. How many of you know the story of Helen Keller? She was born blind and deaf and mute. She could not communicate, she could not hear, she could not speak. But she, at the end of the day, she wrote songs and books that we are still using today for the glory of God. They asked her one question one day. They said, how are you so happy? You can't see, you can't talk. But I just heard the story of how she was, they trained her. They brought her to a teacher that was also a little partially deaf, that she was training deaf people. Maybe she could train her. The woman was frustrated, she couldn't do anything. But one day, water splashed into her hand. And she felt it. And she rubbed the water. And God gave the woman inspiration. If she could feel water, then we could use water to train her for alphabets. And that was when they started the program of training her with water. They would put water in her, maybe 2 drops mean A, 3 drops mean B. They begin to control what's for her. That was how she got to know to read and write. Can you see how God even worked, God worked in her heart? So they asked her a question, how come you are so joyful? Knowing that you can't talk, you can't speak, you can't, you know the response? She said, a blind mind is worse than a blind eye. Say, I cannot see, I cannot hear, but I can see in the spirit. I can hear God in the spirit. So Lord, don't let me be a victim of spiritual deafness and blindness in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me begin to pray in Jesus' name. Father, I pray in Jesus' name. Don't ever let me be a victim of spiritual deafness and blindness all in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Don't let my eyes be blind to what you are showing me. Don't let my ears be lost, be deaf to what you are saying to me. Help me. Open my eyes, open my ears so I can see, I can hear in the name of Jesus Christ. All the days of my life by the power of the Holy Ghost in Jesus. The people of God, pray. Pray in your heart. This is one of the greatest prayers you can pray for yourself. A blind person spiritually, a deaf person spiritually cannot see what God is saying, cannot hear what God is doing, cannot hear what God is saying, cannot see what God is doing, then you'll be stuck in life. You better pray now. Pray for yourself. Pray for your children. Pray for your family. Don't let me and my family and my children ever be a victim of spiritual deafness and blindness in the name of Jesus Christ. Open our eyes, open our ears. Why do you think David prayed? Lord, open my eyes so I can see wonderful things in your word. Thank you, Father, Lord. I receive it, we receive it. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The next one, amen. The next one, I told you we're going to pray. Lord, I receive grace to be obedient to your direction in Jesus' name. It's one thing for God to reveal, to speak. It's another thing to what? To obey. So there's no point just hearing and saying you don't obey. Lord, I receive grace to be obedient to your direction in Jesus' name. Begin to pray in Jesus' name. Father, I receive grace never from this day forward, all the days of my life, in the name of your Christ, to be obedient to your direction. Every time you speak, every time you reveal, every time I see, every time I hear you, Lord, I receive grace to be obedient to your direction all the days of my life in Jesus' name. Mazakaya, I receive the grace for me and my family, for my wife, for my children. I receive grace for all our church members, our family members over the world who will hear, who will see, be obedient what God is saying in Jesus' name. Gazakata broke you again. Man Zakata ask, get a soul to you. In Jesus' name, we pray. The next one. You're going to say, I curse every root of confusion, root of pride, and root of misdirection in my life in Jesus' name. I don't can curse the victory. You're going to curse. You're going to say, I curse every root of confusion, every root of pride, every root of misdirection in my life in the name of begin to curse it in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I curse every root of confusion, I curse every root of pride, I curse every root of misdirection in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. That will be hindrances to the voice of God, to the divine guidance of God in me. I curse you in the name of Jesus Christ. Man Zakayaba, I curse in the life of all our church members, all our family members, and my family members, and my children, in the name of Jesus Christ. You, every root of confusion, every root of pride, every root of misdirection, I curse you in the name of Jesus Christ. Man Zakayaba, Mapatakayaba Baba, Man Zeketekelebo, Man Zeketekelebo, Son Toya. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The next one. I come against the spirit of fear in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Like I said, fear not. Fear will hinder obedience. Fear will hinder moving in the direction of God. God is saying something, but you are so afraid to take the step. Fear will hinder the faith that's supposed to rise up in you when you hear from God. So I want us to pray. I come against the spirit of fear. It's a spirit. The ball for God, I don't give it a what? The spirit of fear. So I bind and I come against the spirit of fear. But let me begin to pray in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind and I come against the spirit of fear in my life. In Jesus' name, and the life of every member of this church, Jubilee Land, and all the family members, in the life of my wife, my children, I bind every spirit of fear. I cast out of our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind you. I come against you in our life. You will not prosper anymore. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will not torment us anymore, but the Bible says fear is a torment. You will not torment, we will find you. In Jesus' name, we pray. The next one. In case I have taken a wrong step in any area of my life, Lord, by your grace, pull me out now in Jesus' name. In case I have taken any wrong step, it will be stupidity for that. You know, the Bible says that's the way that seems right to a man. And the end of it is, you know, in case I don't know, God wants me to go south, I'm going north, I will end nowhere. He's fruitless, it's frustration. So, Lord, in case I have taken any wrong step in my life, any wrong in my life, Lord, by your grace, pull me out now in the name of Jesus. Let me begin to pray in Jesus' name. Father, I pray in Jesus' name, Lord, in case I have taken a wrong step in any area of my life, Lord, by your grace, this moment, this hour, pull me out in Jesus' name. In any area of my life, I have taken any wrong step, Lord, pull me out. Don't let me go any time further. Because you will be foolish then to continue to go in the wrong direction. In the name of Jesus Christ. Manzakaya, Jesus Brokaya. Manzakayaba. I pray for all our church members, all our family members. In case anybody has taken a wrong step in any area of life, Lord, by your grace, pull them out. I pray, pull them out in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray. Let me tell you how powerful this prayer is. No, because I love to use practical things. Please, you're from North Carolina. You're going to North Carolina and you're driving towards New York. Tell me, does that make sense? Okay, how many hours is New York to Maryland? About 4 hours. The same hours it's going to take you to get. Then I ended up arriving at Bronx, New York. So what will happen? You have to turn around. Do you see? Do you see how many hours now going to take you to turn back and now start driving back to North Carolina? But if you know ahead of time, maybe after 30 minutes drive, my goodness, I'm on the way to New York. No, I'm gonna, you turn around. Does that make sense? That's why this prayer is so important. So the next prayer point, the last one. This is the last one, yeah. Lord, I receive grace for you to always be first in my life in Jesus' name. Because when God is first in your life, you want to obey Him. When God is first in your life, when He speaks, Lord, is that what you're saying? At your will, sir. At your command, sir. You give me salute. Go ahead. But when God is not first in your life, it's a struggle. That's why a lot of people, when God wants to do something great in their life, they can't arrive at greater. Why? They always struggle with God. Because God is not first in their life. When God is first in your life, it's easy to obey Him. Amen. Praise the Lord. If you don't love, look, I love my wife. Every time she tells me something, every time she, she counsels me, I want to listen, I want to please her, I want to satisfy her. You understand what I'm saying? Love. A lot of people just follow God for protection. They don't love Him. So that's why they find it difficult to obey Him. Even if they are seeing the truth, they are reading to them, they want excuses. Why? They don't love Him. Because if you love Him, you ought to be first in your life. In fact, my prayer is that the love of God will rise up in your heart and in the heart of everybody to love God. The Bible says Solomon, 1 Kings chapter 3, Solomon loved God. And everything was going great for him. You read the Bible. But the moment, the Bible says Solomon loved God and he built a great house for God, right? A great temple. But Solomon, the Bible now says, and Solomon loved strange women. Guess what? He was building houses for all those women too. So he built more houses for his girlfriend and his wife before what he got. Look at his end. He said, everything is what? Vanity. He was doing well from the beginning, but the moment his heart shifted to women, that was it. He couldn't obey God anymore. The Bible says he offered strange sacrifice to strange God. But his beginning was offered sacrifice to the God of Israel, the God of heaven indeed. But the moment we begin to offer strange sacrifices to other God, God departed from him. His fame began to go down. He began, the money that was making and the fame and the wisdom that was making it great now becoming like a curse. He now hated money, he hated wisdom, he hated fame, he hated everything. So they said that I could see him at the end of the day. He was always dying depressed. He said, everything just started. Our case will not be like that in Jesus. Amen. So Lord, I receive grace for you to always be first in my life. Then begin to pray in Jesus' name. Father, I receive grace in Jesus' name for you to always be first in my life. I receive that grace for myself, for my wife, for my children, for my husband, for all our Lord, all over, for all the church members during Maryland. Grace that Lord, you want to be first in our life. In any area of life, you want to be first. We consider you first before we consider ourselves, before we consider anything or anybody else. You first in our life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Now let's take the oil. Now, if you are listening to me, if you are not giving your life to Jesus Christ, let me tell you something. God will only tell you one thing, that you give your life to Jesus Christ so you can be saved. See, all the divine direction for protection, for preservation of life, all they were saying, He will not apply to you because you are not His child yet. You are God's creation, but you are not His child. Until you give your life to Jesus Christ that died for your sins, and I pray that God did that for you, that He killed His only Son so that you can be saved. Then, when you receive Him to your life, you become the child of God, and God will give you all your sins. If you are right now listening to me, you want me to pray with you, you want to surrender your life to God and to Jesus Christ to be your Lord and Savior, to forgive you your sins, I'm ready to do it for you. All you do is just put your hand in your heart and I will pray with you. Are you ready? And repeat after me. Just say, Father, I come to you as a sinner, forgiving all my sins. Wash me clean by the blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus, I welcome you to my life. Be my Lord and be my Savior. forever. Thank you for saving my life. Thank you for giving your spirit and your grace for me to serve you all the days of my life. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Now say, devil, I renounce you and your ways in my life. I don't belong to you anymore. And I belong to Jesus Christ forever. In Jesus' name. Congratulations. Welcome to the family of God. You're on your way to heaven. Your name now written down in the book of life in heaven. Listen, if you have done that, you will see, you know, underneath the bottom of your YouTube, whatever you're watching, there's a link there. Please help us fill your name there, your information, and send it to us. We want to continue to pray for you and have contact with you so that we can follow up with you. Congratulations, you are welcome to God's family in Jesus' name.